began this mystery of March Mammal Madness, we discovered most of the rodents were clustered in the red and fur division. But why? Was there a secret league of red-headed rodents working together? Join us as we investigate the riddle of the red division. We stayed on the trail of the wildcard winning Vole and tracked it to the Charles Darwin Reserve in Western Australia. The red kangaroo was casually grazing nearby. Was this some sort of covert meetup? No! The tiny vole was terrified by the giant marsupial's gigantic feet and scampered away into the scrub brush, leaving the kangaroo to hop into the next round. This matchup, the maroon langur weighs in at 30.9 stoats, while the little red flying fox weighs in at only 2 stoats. Night fell in the Borneo forest, and the langur settled down to sleep. Suddenly, it heard a noise and called out.
Shut up! What?
The little red flying fox flitted nearby, searching for nectar, when it was trapped in a net. Humans hunt the flying foxes and eat them, sad to say. The langur, meanwhile, went to sleep, blissfully unaware of its victory. A suspicious meeting took place near a park bench in California. The ring-tailed vancera climbed into a nearby trash can. Did it find a clue? No, it found a hamburger. The red fox, also hungry and hoping to find a snack, surprised the vancera. They stared at each other. Then the fox lunged and chomped. The vancera and the hamburger are no more.
MC. You may ask, where in the world is Carmen Squirrel Diego? Well, I'm here in Botswana, with a chilling tale to tell. The red hearted beast was standing in the grass when it was startled by the red squirrel, dashing toward a tree for safety. The hearted beast also started running towards the tree. It ran into the squirrel and then ran over it. The squirrel has been squished over and out.
In the opening chapters of the March Mammal Madness mystery, the higher-ranked creatures enjoy home habitat advantage. So it was here where the Siberian weasel found itself on the much warmer home turf of the red brocket in Brazil. The weasel bounded up to the startled brocket.
Hello.
They regarded each other. The weasel then bounded off in search of shade and food, leaving the confused brocket standing alone.
AMC, look, I'm in disguise.
Okay, well, anyway, I followed our suspects to Santa Marta, Colombia. The squirrel was getting settled in the trees when, pow, the tree rat showed up and started punching the squirrel. Quit kidding! It was all back, 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 pow, boom, bing, bing. It was great. And anyway, the squirrel just picked up and spread its arms and glided away. And that was the last I saw of it. Go, tree rat! Back to you. Pow, 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 pew. The enigmatic bay cat is very hard to find, but we tracked it down in Borneo, where it was searching for food. The red-rumped agouti had discovered a feast of palm fruit on the forest floor and was oblivious to any approaching danger. The bay cat edged forward, then pounced and chomped. It was truly a study in scarlet. The agouti has been eliminated. The red-necked paddy melon was nervously sitting under a tree in Madagascar when it heard a ruckus above it. What could it be? Was it a group of Tasmanian devils somehow up above it in the trees? The paddy melon did not stick around to find out. It fled the scene, leaving the red-ruffed lemurs above it to celebrate loudly. Obviously, the reddish rodents were only red herrings. How disappointing. Nevertheless, we are still on the case. Join us next time. I am MC Marmot, and this is the mysterious March Mammal Madness.